here we are at the center, at the heart of the Jewish Marais, which is seen as the key Jewish place in Paris.
When Jews were expelled from the city 600 years ago, it was here in the Marais district that they settled. The Marais was just outside the city wall at the time.
You have a lot of Jews either coming from Alsace and Lorraine or coming from Eastern Europe. Walking in the Marais at the beginning of the 20th century, you would hear these people talking in French, talking in Yiddish, arguing to each other.
It was called the Plätzl, meaning little place in Yiddish, because of its narrow streets and small buildings.
You also have elements which are linked to the history of Jews in North Africa, in Eastern Europe, and different chapters of the history of Jews in France, pleasant ones and more difficult ones. If you would ask someone in Paris, where can I have some Jewish food, the answer would be La Rue des Rosiers and some falafel. I like living in the Marais because I like the mixture between the museums, the history, the beautiful architecture, and also the bars, the cultural life, the movies, the cafes. Here we are in the historic center, the heaven of the Jewish gastronomy in Le Marais. Here, this place is the key place when you want to discover and travel in the Jewish past and present when it comes to gastronomy. I am testing this new recipe of the cheesecake with pistache. Bon appétit.
Oh, c'est bien.
The synagogue of La Rue des Tournelles, built in the 19th century. It is the biggest active synagogue in the Marais, used today by visitors and for holidays.
I live in the Marais since 1957. It's changed a lot. The people are not, they ignore almost our history. My father was deported. I had a mother who tried to hide us, my brother who was 4 and I was 10, to different families.
Between 1940 and 1944, when the Vichy regime was in power, the French authorities worked as accomplices with the Nazis, and they managed to deport 1/4 of the Jews who were in France at the time. The Shoah Memorial, which is a place of history, remembrance, and also education. The wall of the names is the list of the 76,000 Jews who were killed from France during World War II by the Nazis and with the strong help of the Vichy authorities. Here, when you look at these names, you can see the diversity of the people who were killed. Children, families, old people, young people. When you look at the names, know where they could come from, who they were. And you can imagine what was their life and to realize what is the amount of destruction that took place.
Place des Vosges, one of the most beautiful squares of Paris and the home of Victor Hugo, lies adjacent to the Jewish quarter. The Jewish Museum of Paris, located in a large mansion built in 1650, they tell the story of the French Jewish community and its great contribution to the state and its culture, from the Middle Ages through the Renaissance and the Emancipation to the present day.
You have a real Jewish community at the time of the French Revolution, where Jews are emancipated, when they can be part of the society.
Alfred Dreyfus, captain in the French army at the end of the 19th century, is the most famous example of the paradox of French Jewish life. Accused of betraying France for Germany, he was sent to jail. On one hand, it shows how strong antisemitism was in certain elements of the French society, such as the army and the Catholic Church. And on the other, there were writers, such as Émile Zola, civic leaders, and many others who defended Dreyfus. Jews have contributed to all aspects of French culture, science, and public life. For instance, Léon Blum, Prime Minister of France in the 1930s, Henri Bergson, philosopher, Camille Pissarro, the Impressionist painter, Simon Veil, a public leader. Writers such as Marcel Proust and Romain Gary, painters like Modigliani, and the Rothschild family of bankers and philanthropists.
And since the 1950s and the decolonization, you have a very strong influx of Jews coming from North Africa into France and has been reshaping the cultural, the religious identity of French Jewry. So you can see that it's often tragic to be a Jew in France, and at the same time, we see that hundreds of thousands of Jews have made their lives here, decided to continue their life, and if they stay here, it's because they believe it's their home.